first off, you know, I gotta thank God. You know, I live a blessed life. You know, I get to fight in front of the world once again. So thanks to my team, Boxing Star Management. The fact that this fight got done without me even signing with them is unheard of in the game. You know, they're not charging me an arm and a leg for me to get this fight done. And, you know, I got a great team behind me. And as far as, you know, the Rosado part, you know, I don't really hate Rosado. I don't really like him. Like, the man literally turned Hollywood. He's still wearing glasses inside. He literally moved to Hollywood. He left his coach to go to Hollywood. And then that didn't work out and came back to his coach. And me and I stayed down. I stayed loyal to my coach. I had my first coach, Eddie Mustafa Muhammad. I had 10 fights with him. Win, lose, or draw, look good or look bad, stay with him. Went with John David Jackson, 10 fights. We looked bad in our last fight, and we got right back to work. You know, and as far as all this experience bullshit, like, it's all losses, man. Like, you don't get props for getting experience and losing. You know, like, what? Now you're trying to switch it up?
Any of my losses is better than any of your wins.
No, it's not. A loss is not good, bro. At the end of the day, a loss is not good at all. And the reason you had to fight people back to back was because you kept losing. If you would have kept winning and looking good, they wouldn't have made you fight these dogs. But you just kept losing, and they needed a TV fight. So they're like, fuck it, just put Rosado in there. He gonna fight, he just gonna bring his head up and just let him get beat up. You know, you got a good name, and you know that. You promoted yourself good, you know, but your name at the end of the day. And the only thing my resume needed is a name, you know? So you're the name that I needed. And Saturday night, I'm gonna prove it. And I like the fact that you forgot about that 10 racks. You know what I mean? Like, don't forget you signed. You shook on that. So I got my 10 bands right here. I don't need none getting taken out of my purse. And since we're in a casino, you know, I love to gamble. I'm willing to up that another 5 racks on a knockout. So if I knock you out, it's 15. And if it goes to the decision, it's 10. So like you said, you ready. You said you got your trainer over there. You know, you back your other trainer. You know, you're gonna try to box. You're gonna try to box and moves. It says, when the hell do you box and move? That's it, you just starting up with excuses already. You don't teach old dogs new tricks. You've never been a boxer, so don't even try that shit again. Hey, I'm gonna dictate the fight. You're not gonna be able to do nothing. No, I got my shit ready. Everything is on point. There will be no excuses this fight. You know, and so when I smoke you, I want my 10,000. And if I knock you out, I want my 15,000. And that's it.
You are who you are.
No, and who are you?
The ring exposed you.
The ring? Man, I had one bad fight. You had 11, bro. You had 11. You talked a lot of smack too. And you lost. You got them glasses on because you're covering up all them fucking scars you got. All them damn scars, man. Look at that boy gonna cut
all the
east.
Not pretty.
You're not that pretty, bro. You're not that pretty, bro. You're not that pretty. I mean, I'm straight. So like I said, Saturday night, we still in the show. I'm still in the show. Because it ain't much he gonna be able to do but just catch a beating. I'm gonna look good. I feel good. Training camp was excellent. And I'm ready to put on a show. And like I said, man, I got my money where my mouth is. Where your money at? You the one that shook on it. I was only going to bet 5. I know I'm getting more money than him. But he wanted to up it to 10. So, okay, we shook on it. So I got my $10 right here. Where your money at? Hey, if I knock him out, I need 15 from his purse. And if I beat him decision, which he might be able to hold on for 12 rounds, I need 10. So,
Luis,
you don't got your money right there, so I'm ready.
A couple of questions.
What's
I
up,
get the feeling that the winner of this fight is going to make a lot more than $15,000 moving forward. But anyway, you, and I mean this disrespectfully, you always talk a great game. You did it in the Jacobs fight. You didn't deliver. What's the difference this time around that we'll see you deliver on Saturday night?
I'm just more mature. You know, I'm in a better stage in my life. I'm more comfortable. You know, I jumped on the opportunity. I mean, if I had, you know, my team was a little better, they would have knew I wasn't ready for that fight. They were just looking for an opponent for Jacobs. I saw the opportunity, I saw the money, and I took it. You know, I mean, I obviously was not ready for that stage, but I'm stronger, I'm better, I'm smarter. You know, all the details are fixed. You know, I got everything online, so it won't be no excuses this fight. So I'm ready.
You've seen, after the Jacobs loss, nearly 12 months of inactivity. You know now about boxing, how difficult it is to get the opportunities when you lose. Yeah. Is that giving you more hunger going into this fight? Because basically you can't afford to lose this fight.
Yeah. No, it's giving me more hunger. You know, I just sat back and I just, you know, just relaxed. You know, it was just, I could have took a bunch of fights, you know. I could have fought an easy-ass Glenn Tapia and got me a couple of little easy wins. I could have went down to Mexico and paid a little couple thousand and got my record up to 20-24-1. But for what? Those fights are just meaningful. They don't mean nothing. So I just waited around. I waited around for the perfect opportunity to get the perfect fight. And the fight happened. It took a year. Well, whatever. We were in the gym working the whole time.
Finally, last question. How do you win the fight on Saturday night? And does it come inside the distance? Obviously, you put your money in. You 100% believe you knocked out.
I don't think this fight going the distance. But, you know, it just... The man's he got too much miles on him, you know? As long as I stay consistent to my game plan, just keep touching him up, keep the pressure on him. He now all of a sudden he wanna box. Cause when the fuck, you know what I mean? So, but as long as I do me, I keep the pressure on him. I keep the fight in the middle of the ring. You know what I mean? It's not gonna be that tough of a fight. You know, I plan on looking very impressive on Saturday.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is gonna be a great fight. Big round of applause, please, for Luis Arias. Now, you two have got to follow this up, I think. We'll give it a try. I have to say that, obviously, being a Brit, you know, I've got a lot of love for Clarissa Shields, but Hannah Rankin is here from Scotland. We've got a lot of great Scottish fighters. In our stable, Ricky Burns, John Doherty, etc., etc. But I've seen this young lady fight recently in a great fight in the States. I've seen her prepare for this fight. I think she's looking fantastic in preparation. It's a big opportunity for her.